make it look so easy.
So.
I'm actually just gonna break one of the rules that I said. This is a small horseshoe. That horseshoe you had, I don't think you could have done this, but that little bend, with it being nice, I'm just gonna save a little bit of time and hit it a couple of times. If I had to hit it more than three times, I'd probably get it fired and keep it up. Just doing that quick little. Yeah, short as that is, the whole thing's hot. Hot by normal food standards. Cold by our mood standards. So, I'm going to forge this taper. And you can see that there's a little bit of that crease that's closed up. So you can see, you know, about how much material is actually going to get drawn out. And that's what it's called. You're going to draw out a taper. We're going to make this longer. We're going to draw it out. You can see that still, it's going to be square. I'm just going to work two sides. I want you to notice what I do and how I do it. And like before, I'm not going to talk for the first one, and then I'll explain it in a second. What did you notice?
Pretty heavy blows.
That was what I was talking about earlier. You're actually putting a little bit on it that time.
You're squeezing it.
Yeah, you were squishing all that. And how are we squishing it? You were kind of, be a little bit more specific with your answer. I flipped it, but I flipped it in a very specific way.
Back and forth.
And then what would I do? Flip it back. So it's not a four-sided, let's do it like that. It is two sides. There are blacksmiths out there that will flip all four sides.
The anvil does have to work.
Yeah. So why am I going to actually turn loose? You see how I'm having to adjust my grip on the tongs. I want to work fast. I got a limited amount of heat. So I'm going to hit and flip. I never turn loose, and all I have to do is flex that wrist just a little bit, and I'm able to get there. You'll notice that all of a sudden, if you go rhombus, it'll be incredibly apparent very quickly. There is a technique, you can hit those edges and kind of drive that rhombus back. It's completely recoverable. So there's an old Japanese tale of these, you know, samurai sword makers that say they lit their fire by taking a cold piece of metal and hit it back and forth like that so fast that it began to glow, and then they could stick it in their tinder bundle in their forge and start their fire. Well, why is that even possible? Yeah, if you hit this side and then you hit that side and you're able to do it fast enough, you're compressing that metal slightly and you're creating friction, which equates to heat energy, right? So now,